My name is Andy. How's everybody doing?
I am the Zach Monson. Welcome to another edition of Pause Play here at Canadian Music Week. We are joined today by Canada's very own Andy. How are you doing?
I'm very good, thank you. How are you?
I'm very, very good. Thanks so much for coming to the show. So what have you guys been up to at CMW so far the last couple days?
Well, today we were playing at the Radio Music Awards.
Yeah.
And we had a blast. I was nominated for Best New Artist, so it was such an honor to be here for the first time at the Canadian Radio Music Awards.
Amazing.
And it was actually our second show last week. We played at CMW for the first time. It was our first show as a band. And yeah, it was about a year ago, so I'm still with the same guys today.
Good. How did music start in your life? When did you kind of know that music was going to be the path that you take?
When I started to talk.
Okay.
I remember I liked singing better than talking. So it was always around in my family. I grew up in a musical family. Mom and dad played. Started to sing at the church. The mass was like my first gig. So after, I remember playing at a... Well, singing at the church and telling my mom after, Mom, I know I can do that. I'm going to be a singer. Yeah. And they have always supported me since then, yeah.
And what was the first album and the last album that you purchased?
The first album was Laundry Service by Shakira.
Okay.
I was also trying to do the moves.
Yeah.
The last album was Sound of a Woman by Kaiza.
What an incredible album.
Very, very good. And she was, I was curious to see, listen to her music. And I think she was a fantastic performer too.
Yeah, you saw her show?
Yeah, she was performing right before me, and I saw it from backstage.
Oh, amazing.
It was great.
What a wonderful, wonderful artist. You know, so you started writing music at around, the age of 10 or 11.
Yeah.
Do you remember the first song that you ever wrote?
It was called Let Me Be.
Okay, and what was it? What was Let Me Be about?
Let It Be. It was about my first crush, I guess. Let Me Be Someone. That's all I remember. Yeah. But I actually performed that song in front of my school, and I was about 13. And I performed it once, and that's it. I never performed it again because I realized it was kind of shitty.
It sounded beautiful. What I just got sounded lovely. So, you've been writing for the last, 15 years. What do you find you write about most now?
Well, as my album title is Black and White Heart. So it's really a lot about my ups and downs, my own personal black and white moments.
Yeah.
And there's a big contrast between the songs. And on my album, I talk a lot about glorious relationships and existential crisis and it's about all my moods and my crazy
That's a fair answer. Speaking of Black and White Heart, it's also the title track on the album. Tell me about how this song came to you, because I heard you kind of had the idea for your album done and then the song came to you and everything changed. So what happened there?
Yeah, about a year ago, all the album had been recorded, and it was about the fear of falling in love, the fear of being in a relationship, because I had a bad experience before, and I was kind of scared of being in a new relationship, and I don't know, it just inspired me that song. And before I finished the song, I told my label, I have a song, it's called Black and White Heart. I want it to be the title of the album, and it's gonna be like this, and the artwork is gonna be me opening up my chest.
Yeah.
And they were like, okay.
Yeah.
But the song wasn't done. They had not heard the song, but I have the chance to have a team of people who really trust me, and they went with this idea. They thought it was good. So, yeah.
We asked the last artist to ask you a question.
Yeah.
So here is that question.
Hi, my name is Eric Zane, and my question for you is, if you had a sixth sense, what would it be? And you're not allowed to say intuition.
I would like to read people's mind.
That's a great one.
Yeah.
I would be terrified of that.
Yeah, right.
I don't think I want to know what everybody's thinking all the time.
No, I just don't think I want to know. I think it's fascinating.
Yeah. I think you'd hear things that you don't want to hear, I feel like. People think things that it's not great all the time. That's not good.
Maybe I have a sixth sense.
Yeah, maybe. What am I thinking right now?
Oh, my God. You can't
okay,
say
yeah.
that.
Okay, you can read minds. That's fine. You can read minds. If music never happened to you, what do you think you'd be doing?
I would probably be a stay-at-home mom.
Okay.
I would have kids. And be a mom full time.
Do you think that having kids, you know, in the near future, what do you think the major difficulty is going to be trying to keep your musical career and having a family at the same time?
I'm going to have really understanding husband, I guess.
Yeah, those are good. Those are good. Understanding husband.
Stay at home husband.
I would love to do that. Hang out, watch Netflix. It sounds fantastic. I love that. I can mop a floor too, so it's good. As a Canadian musician, what are some other great Canadian artists that you like right now?
I'm a big fan of Half Moon Run.
Yeah.
Franklin Electric.
Love Franklin Electric.
Bryan Adams.
Amazing.
Gotta see
Bryan Adams wandering around the floor. He actually touched my shoulder last night.
Oh my God.
I know. We're pretty much best friends now.
Also love Alejandra Rivera.
Very good.
She's one of my favorites.
Amazing, amazing stuff. Where can people see you perform in the near future?
See me perform? Well, I'm going to release my album on May 26th in Montreal. At Jack Saloon, Old Montreal. And yeah, we're going to have a big release party. Yeah. That's nothing else announced for yet for
okay.
now.
Well, let us know. We'll let people know where they can see you in the next future. You can hear Andy on Stingray Music's Hit List channel and Top Day Chat channel. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank
you. Are you going to play some songs for us?
Yeah, of course. With
amazing.
Half of my band.
Your band hanging out behind camera
yeah,
there. They're giving
already.
Us a big nod. Excellent. Can't wait. Tune in next time, guys.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for watching. Click on the left to subscribe to Pause Play. Click on the right to watch more videos.